ReefDVMs coming at you with kind of a summer education opportunity that we had. Oh, what a blessing. We got to head out to the Olson Ranch out in Colorado and do some driving lessons. And I'm talking some big draft horse driving lessons. They have on their ranch, Bob and Julie Olson, a carriage and basically like a repair shop for harnesses and so forth. And they also have a driving school. It's a driving school that's very personal, very warm and welcoming. And it can be as, you know, short as just a few days to a whole week. These folks have some incredible draft horses from about 16 some hands all the way up into the 18 hands category. And they're beautiful horses. Yeah, they've got some other horses on the place too. But for our sake, during the week that we're there, we're working with the Pertrons pretty much exclusively. It's really kind of a fantastic place. It starts out with the basic knowledge of everything from the collar to the harnesses, and you do put them on a lot. You're doing some chores with these horses. You're brushing and grooming and prepping them to wear these harnesses, and you're trying to learn and understand as much as you can in that week you're there with everything to do with how to properly and safely hook up these horses with their harnesses. Bob is a fantastic teacher. He's extremely patient. He's definitely hands-on. He judges what you need skill at and what you don't need skills at based on your horsemanship, and he works with you. This isn't all just about, you know, contacting a horse either. There are times where you are looking at diagrams and pictures, understanding angles and pull, but it's not most of the time. It helps you with the leads. They've got photographs and pictures and paperwork that'll help you. And then they take you out and they start you doing basic things. Now, these are all well-broke team horses. They've been on 6-hitch, 4-hitches, 2-hitches, and singles. But Bob starts out with the basics. And the basics is learning how to harness them up and get the bridles and the hames on correctly. And then you're out doing groundwork. This is my wife. She's out working one of the big girls here. It's kind of fun. And then once you get done with that, then he starts showing you carts. And oh my, does he have carts. I would say there's at least a half dozen carts on the place. And then there's wagons to use. It's fantastic to see the different sizes. He's got them from basically halflinger size on up. So you really get a feel for what you can drive. In this case, this is myself out there on one of the carts from Pioneer. I really fell in love with this cart. And, you know, again, we're not off to the races and plowing through the fields and the woods. And no, we're starting out with, you know, stopping and backing up. Very simple procedures on day two and three, but we did a lot of this. Getting that horse to be able to pivot, haw and gee, it was fantastic. And he's so patient with us, even when we screw up and put the horse in the wrong direction. It was fantastic. Now, once we got done with the basics, the groundwork, and, you know, backing up and turning, you know, he certainly did. He took us out. He's got a nice oval dirt track that you get to drive on. And we did a lot of laps on that in different directions, turning and circling and stopping and starting. And this is my wife here, Molly, coming across. She's on that same Pioneer cart. We really enjoyed this cart, as you can see by the video. We spent a lot of time in it, and that was somewhat our choice. I mean, Bob and Julie would pull out other pieces of equipment for us, but we kept coming back to this just because it was very easy and comfortable for us to learn on. And the other person, which is myself in the class, we get to back off and get a break while that student is learning. And that break is quite needed. These classes, you start, you know, 8, 9 in the morning, and you're done at 4 or 5 o'clock at night. So it's a long day, but it's a beautiful day out in Colorado learning this. I'd highly recommend if somebody really wants even a nice vacation and wants to learn how to drive, come on out, meet these folks, and go through it with them. It's fantastic out here. So here I am. I'm on a kind of a covered wagon, but doesn't have the canvas top on it. And I've got a team of horses here in front of me, a two team, and I have hitched them up and got them ready. And then I'm out driving them. And then this is at another point. My wife Molly is out on one of the gravel roads with them. It's just, it's scenic. It's beautiful out here. And there are times where you're kind of off-road too. Here she's plowing through some ponderosa pines with a pair of girls. It's just, it's a fantastic learning experience. I can't say enough. It's certainly going to enhance our ability to drive better. It's certainly going to bring this valuable trade back to the farm. It's fantastic to see these majestic beauties and be behind them on a cart. I can't say enough to the people who own the school and the time they take for us. You know, God bless them both. They're hardworking folks, and they put together a heck of a school. I'm not saying it's cheap, but it was probably the best vacation money we've spent in the last probably 3 or 4 years. It was fantastic. I appreciate you all watching, folks. Thanks for liking our channel and subscribing. We'll keep putting out more great videos like this.